Okay, let's continue. I'm gonna skip this part of the proof. You can prove it. You can do as an exercise. Universal property of primes, and then you have to prove, and then you prove that it has twice the prove the class of this, well, what I'm calling this map, a psi, this psi, that the class of the push forward, or the class of the image of psi this here is twice the minimal class on the prim of the other one. How to call it? Yeah, the class g minus 2 over g minus 2 factorial. Well, this is a general construction. Let me see the genus is correct. G minus one. G minus the dimension of P. I think it's G minus two. Yeah, it's correct. Mm-hmm. By the generation, you can use the same method by the generation. Okay. Yeah, but I'm working in G equals six. Okay. Now let's do this globally. So let's define M6 tetragonal. Coming back to genus six, is the modular space parametrizing the pairs of a curve and 1G4. C is in M6. Okay, that's a modular space. Now, you forget the G14. This is, in general, is what I my mistake of yesterday. In general, a curve of genus 6 will have only 5 of G14s. Mm-hmm. And so you have degree 5 here. This is a finite map. Mm-hmm. Now by base change, you can extend to R6. So you have this R6 goes to P6 from to a it's not P6, sorry. This is also the forgetful map over M6. You forget the covering, you have M6. Tetragonal. So you have an object defined here. I call it R6 tetragonal. Okay. Mm-hmm. So the tetragonal construction keeps a correspondence. Okay, I have to tell you what the correspondence is. Of degree 10, 10, no, 2, 2 over here. Mm-hmm. So what is this correspondence? Is a subspace in the Cartesian product of R6, such that I don't know, it's hesitated to give a name. It's a correspondence. They are pairs, C tilde, C, F, and they are pairs. C prime, F prime, C prime, F prime, mm-hmm. In R6, that's the elements in R6 tetragonal, such that they are tetragonal related. tetragonally related. So I can go from one to the other by this procedure. And this does define a correspondence. It's the degree 2, 2, because when I project, project to one factor, the fiber has degree 2. Yes, for one, I have two others that I can construct in this way. And this 2, 2, because it's symmetric, you have two projections, right? You have projection 1, projection 2. This in each projection is 2, 2, 1. Okay. And at the level of M6, you have a 10-10 correspondence on you call it, don't I call it tetragonal in R6. Mm-hmm. So essentially you forget the G14. Just skip the coverings. Mm-hmm. Mm. Tetragonally related. But this is 10-10. And this is 10-10 because of the fact I told you about the lines in the cubic surface. Every line in a cubic surface, smooth cubic surface, intersect at 10 others. 10 others. Mm-hmm. Okay. So this is the geometry. So I want to write the theorem to Tsutsunagi. So the correspondence tetragonal. Correspondence tetragonal on the in the inverse image of a generic A or abelian variety of dimension 5 or generic A in A5. Now is any generic abelian variety of dimension 5. This is isomorphic to the incidence correspondence of the 27 lens. Correspondence on the 27 lines on a non-singular or smooth cubic surface. This is the theorem. Mm-hmm. So that means that the monodromy of the map is given by the monodromy group of R6 in A5. So that means the Galois group of the Galois closure of this map. So essentially, where do they leave the monodromy of this the on the fibers? Is the Weyl group VE6, which corresponds to all the symmetries of the symmetry group of the 27 lines. Mm-hmm. That preserves the incidence, yeah? Symmetry group of the 27 lines. Mm-hmm. This is very, very, very concrete. And actually, the depth of the different loss size, so we saw the monodromy group can be a little bit smaller. So for instance, that we saw it very clearly in, over the cubic trifolds. Over the cubic trifolds, we saw this group. The monodromy group is WA6. But on the Jacobians, there's some degeneration of that. On the Jacobians A5, Jacobians, the group in the fibers is WD5. So this is the symmetry group of the I should say symmetry group of the incident corresponds. Symmetry group of the 27 lines, but when one line is a marked line, one is fixed. Mm-hmm. Symmetry group of lines in the cubic with one marked one. So with other words, is the stabilator of a line in the W6. So it's a subgroup of W6. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit smaller. Okay. okay. Mm-hmm. And there is another one that I didn't say at all, but it's very, very relevant for other purpose, is the intermediate Jacobians of quartic double solids. Jacobians of quartic double solids. Mm-hmm. And this is the monodromy group is governed by WA5, the viral group of A5, which is isomorphic to the symmetric group S6. So I must say this is also the symmetric group of 27 elements. It's inside. Yeah, because you are moving the lines on 27, so it's a subgroup of the permutation group. That preserves the incidence, and this is S6. That corresponds the group that the symmetric group of lines on a nodal cubic surface. Okay. Now, from all these loci, the only one which is actually a divisor is this one. This is dimension 14. That was 12, and this is the smallest one, 10. And notice that by our discussion, the pre-map fails to be finite over the Jacobians. Yeah, we have a finite fiber, so you have to blow up positive dimensional fibers, and over the other one. Mm-hmm. So it depends on the definition of branch locus, but where it fails to be finite is the branch locus, if we call it B branch locus, the locus of B6. One can show that this is irreducible. It contains these two guys, the locus of Jacobians, the cubic threefolds, and the intermediate Jacobians of those. Mm-hmm. Jacobians of double solids. They are all there. But this is irreducible, and this component, you have a component of dimension 4 that is also reducible. These are the same. And these two are the generation of this one. These two. Well, like this. They are the generations. Mm-hmm. The generation of intermediate Jacobian double solid. So I just want to finish that the branch locus of P6 is also known, and it contains all these guys. So let me see. That finishes my discussion of P6. The original planning was to talk about the other covering Faber's case. But instead of that, okay, I can tell you two words about Faber's case. Just Faber's case. So it's triple cyclic coverings. So there is no reason that why one should restrict ourselves to double coverings. You can consider triple cyclic ones. And let me define some notation. Let's put RGD. It's gonna be the modular space of etal double coverings of degree D, etal, where C is in MG, and is cyclic. I also restrict myself to cyclic for simplicity. Non-cyclic case I have not considered, just over genus two, but it has completely different flavor for many reasons. Okay, so there is an interesting case, Faber case. Faber study P43, the pre-map that associated a triple cyclic covering over a genus four curve. And this goes to P6. I'm gonna tell you know what it is. So you have some covering. You take the kernel of the norm map, the connected component containing the zero. That defines abelian subvariety of the Jacobian of C tilde. I call it also prime variety, although it's not principally polarized, has a polarization, but this polarization is of type. So let me see. This is of dimension. This is genus four. G tilde is 10, and this is dimension six. This is why dimension six. And the polarization is of type 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 3. So it's not polar, it's not principal. Dimension six. This is the type of polarization. Okay. Now, but you don't get all the polarized of that type, no. The image of this pre-map has an extra ingredient, namely the automorphism group. Because since this guy is cyclic, they come with an automorphism of degree three. And then sigma is also an automorphism of the Jacobian, but also is an automorphism of the prime. Induces an automorphism of prime. So I denote P6 by the set of all abelian varieties of dimension six with this polarization 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, such that it exists an automorphism P that preserves the polarization. So when I take the pullback of the polarization, I get algebraic equivalent the same thing. Okay, it's what they call B, or Faber's calls B6. Okay, so just let me tell you his result. His result is, well, in this part, why this case? Because in this case, both this space and the image have the same dimension. And so it's natural, if they have the same dimension, it's natural to think of if it is generically finite or not. And if it's generically finite, what is this degree? And if you know the degree, it has some nice structures like the tetragonal one. Well, it turns out that yes, the answer is yes to that. So let's see, theorem by Faber is that, okay, P4, 3 from R3 to this P6, is generically finite of degree 16. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so both are of dimensions. Okay, let me see. It has the same dimension as the modular space of curves of genus 4 because it's a finite covering of M4. So this is 9. Yeah. Yes, dimension 9. Okay, both have dimension 9. And just to tell you briefly, so essentially Faber follows the steps of Donaghy-Smith. Sometimes it's and so he chooses it's a very tricky choice. He chooses a special fiber where to compute the degree. He computes the degree, so the computation goes on the fiber over the following object. So take a generic curve of genus 3. Generic. And then he defines P as the kernel. So you take the Jacobian 3 times. This is very tricky. 3 times the same Jacobian. And you take the sum of the sum map. You can take one of that, your sum, and you get here. This is an homomorphism of groups. You can consider the kernel. The kernel is naturally a subvariety of the triple, the product of this triple, the Jacobian with themselves. Actually, this is isomorphic as variety, is isomorphic to the Jacobian twice. Yes, yeah, the kernel. But not as polarized abelian varieties. Yeah, so one has to be careful because this has a principal polarization, but it's not the polarization that coming from the restrictions. So this has a principal polarization, and then you restrict the principal polarization to P such that the good part is that the restricted polarization is of the required type. Polarization of the principal one on the product 3 is of type 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 3. Yeah, wonderful. And moreover, since you are taking the product of the 3 objects, you have the symmetric group acting on it. This is cool. You have S3 acting on this, permutated. And this is restricted to the kernel. So something that is in the kernel is permutated, is still in the kernel. So you have, and in particular, you have an automorphism. You have an automorphism of order 3. You take any, you have more than one. Actually, you take the cycles of length 3. So permutation of 3. You have an automorphism on P preserving this polarization of order 3. Okay, so he goes to the same steps that we did it. So first, he extended to allowable coverings, but now there are triplet ones. So the conditions are a little bit different, but you know, the structure of the proof is the same. So how to study what are the allowable covers in this case that extended to that is a proper map. And then you go to study all the possible coverings over this particular Jacobian. He found some sort of version of Vertinghen covers, but with 3. He found also elliptic tails that doesn't count. So it's very similar. And the end structure is this 16 has an structure as well. Let me tell the time. Okay. Mm-hmm. And he proved also that the structure of the fiber is the 16, call it 16-6 Kummer Homer structure. So it's the structure of the 16 lines. So you have a Kummer variety. So what is the Kummer variety? So you have take an abelian surface, principal polarized. You can make the quotient by minus. So this has singularities on the two torsion points, but then you the singularize that. Yes, this just to take the singularization. So over these two double points, you get a line. You have 16 nodes. Oh God. 16 nodes, and over 16 nodes, you have 16 lines here. 16 lines living in this desingularized Kummer surface. And this is 16-6 because the incidence of these lines in S, it can be described by, Faber puts it very nicely, to consider four lines like this. A grill of four horizontal and four vertical lines. So each node in the grill is a line. Yeah. That represents a line. Okay. And the incidence is given by this, for instance, this line intersects all the lines that live in the same column and the same row. So this one intersect other six lines, these ones. This. Yeah. And this little description gives you all the incidence of the 16 lines here. So it's also Del Pezzo. Del Pezzo of degree four. Del Pezzo surface. Okay. That's right. And the automorphism group of these lines, this the incidence, or the symmetry group of the lines is symmetry group. In this case, of the 16-16 structure is S4 times S4. Yeah. Semi-direct product with Z2. Okay, I think this four one is reflected by these four intersections. So you can permutate that one column and one row, and it doesn't change the incidence. Okay. Yes. So I want to finish with some open question. Is there any questions about this Faber case? Anything you want to know particular?
Just one thing in the definition, yes, of P6, upstairs you haven't written that the sigma to the third is identity. So maybe
it has to be of degree three. Yes, that has to be here. Correct. Thank you. Yes. Okay, now let me show you. Okay. So when I look at this paper of Faber, actually at the beginning Faber tried to be a little bit more general. And you say, okay, let's consider all the possible degrees and genus, and if you can have more of these cases where this you can expect to have something generically defined. The difficulty here is that you have to compute this B, right? Because when you consider maps of higher degree, a cyclic maps of high degree, and you have an automorphism, so the image is always something is a particular image of the abelian. The moduli of abelian varieties, because we have an automorphism, and this automorphism will preserve the polarization. So you have to compute the dimension of the image to know when the image, the dimension of the image coincides with the dimension of the coverings. Yeah. So that is one thing. Let's try to be a little bit more general. So you consider in general, as I said, this is the general case that we consider. We have a cyclic one. See. And then let's just allow ramifications. So the degree of P is T. And let's call 2R a ramified or not. This is the degree of the ramification. It's always pair. It's a pair number. And because it's cyclic, it will be always totally ramified. All the ramifications are totally ramified. If D is prime, it can be separate. Okay, but let's give it like this. Okay, so what I was telling you, you can consider always B, D, the subset of the subspace in the modular space of, I don't know, the abelian varieties of the right dimension with the right polarization delta. So the polarization and the dimension depends on the parameter, depends on the degree, the ramification, etc. Okay, but when this is fixed, since this has a cyclic automorphism of order D, it will preserve such that exists, that is the image of the P map, automorphism of P, such that, so as Pavel says, has to be the identity, has to be of order T. This is the polarization, algebraic equivalent, psi. Okay, so the question is, when have the same dimension? It's the dimension of, now I'm going to introduce the notation. Yes, R, G, R, T. I see, plus the dimension of B, T. So these are the coverings. D to one, cyclic, ramified, degree of the ramification is 2R. Okay. So Lange and I were looking at the paper of Faber. Faber studied only the case, concentrated himself to the case or without the ramifications, and he found some cases. Found of course Donaghi's case, his own case, and he mentioned another one very small. And but we thought he has a mistake, and then we wrote another paper about giving this list. And I can give you the answer. Have 5 minutes. Okay. And I wrote this table because I knew that I didn't want to have time to write it up. So this is what went. Yeah. So I want to explain you. So put what we did in this course in a more large picture, and share with you my my big question of this year. So. So we did this case today. 26. This is my list. Lange and I, we work out that the complete list where these two dimensions coincide. And in those cases, the map is generically finite. We know it's generically finite, okay? On those cases. And this is generically finite always. And we have already seen this. And we want to compute all the degrees. First was Donaghi-Smith, the 27. Then we come Faber with the 16. Lange and I will work out the case of cyclic coverings of degree 7 of genus 2 core without ramification. And then there is a very nice paper from, there is two papers that show the same thing in a very different ways. Nagarajan Ramanan using vector bundles. and Bardelli, Chiliberto, and Berra. So you can imagine that they are very different methods. And they studied the case of, double coverings over a genus tree curve, ramified on 4 points. So ramification is twice this, ramified on 4 points. Yes, 4. And then they computed the degrees 3. This is very nice. Actually, Nagara and Ramanan claim that they have a trigonal tetragonal construction with ramified points, which is still don't, I think it must be true, but I still don't, I wanted to write it down properly. And here we have the polarization types. Then there is, we didn't talk about the cases where it's generically injective. And then there's this case of Marcucci and Naranjo over a genus to elliptic curves, double coverings, ramified over 6 points, as toward the degree of ramification. Okay, and then this case is missing, 2, 3, 3. So triple cyclic coverings over a genus two curve ramified in 3 points, but the ramification, so essentially you see 3, 3, 3, 3 to 1. So this is C tilde, ramified over 3 points. This is genus 2, genus 7, and the prim has dimension 5 with this polarization type. I mix up something. Yes, this is not here. Let me think. Yes, as one, this is one, okay? and I wanted to know the degree of here. And we work with, yes.
You have 3 ones and 2 threes because the dimension is 5.
Yeah, but too many ones, right? Yeah, that's right. Thank you. So the number of here has good concept with the P, dimension of P. I hope there is no other mistake. Okay, now what did they write here? So when I, the first time I wrote down this table, I didn't write it in this order. I didn't know, I didn't want to have an order, particular order. But then some person with a good observation, namely Roy Smith, from Donaghy Smith, he told me, I look at the table and you notice these numbers here are precisely the number of lines on a Del Pezzo surface of this degree. Yes? And if you believe in the conspiracy theories, this number that you're looking for should be 6. Because I have an answer, but I don't have a proof. So this is a conjecture. So the conjecture is that this number is 6. Based in this observation, but this observation means nothing because so far these Del Pezzo surfaces, well, yeah, they are present in the construction, but they are present in a very intricate ways, in a small fiber, all over the place. You don't know exactly. So my question to you guys, I mean, is I want to find some common denominator to all these constructions that should be based on this observation of the number of lines of the Del Pezzo surface. It's something bigger that I am missing. So far, our biggest weapon was this tetragonal construction, trigonal constructions that you move around, but we don't have anything else. And I think I can prove it to the degree 6, but I still don't have a clear idea how is that related to the lines on the Pezzo surface of degree 6. So this n, I'm sorry, should be the degree is 9 minus n, right? I knew this. Degree is 9 minus n. And this is the number of points that you blow up in 6, MP2. So for instance, this 3 is to blow up 6 points. Yeah, it's how do you construct the cubic surface? By blowing up a P2 on 6 points. This is you blow up the 16, you blow up a P2 in 5 points and so on. I think so. Yes, that's correct. This is number of points you blow up. This is N to blow up. Okay, now for once I finish on time. And do you have any questions?
Sorry.
Is the monotomy group in this locus like the wire group of the associated Lie algebra?
I have that in those cases. In two cases, yes. But in this case, I don't know. Once you have this observation, so I obtained it by computation of the degree, but I didn't have this structure. Yes. And it should be there also, the structure, but I don't see it. Yes, it's also a question. This I don't know. Only these two cases are the well understood in terms of the structure.
Faber's case is also where, okay.
Yeah, it's this 16-6 comma, yes.
I'm also wondering, what about the degree one and degree two de Poisson surveys?
Oh, that's also a good question. Why are not in the list? I don't know. There are too many lines, I think. Too many. I think it starts to be very big. I don't know, some hundreds of them. I don't know. No, not hundreds, but too many. Don't know. Maybe appears in other forms. Why? No, I don't know. No, I have no precise answer.
Angela, maybe we have to find something which is not cyclic, or you know,
That's a good guess. Yes. Okay. That list. We restrict ourselves to the cyclic cases.
I have a question. When you talk about cyclic, you mean simple cyclic or arbitrary cyclic? So simple cyclic means, say, if you wanted the degree n, you take a divisor which is a multiple of n. But if, for instance, if you take p1 to p1, which maps z to z cubed, this is not simple cyclic because it's ramified over two points, which is not divisible by three, but it's still cyclic, of course. So in this example, is it always simple cyclic?
Yeah, simple cyclic. Yes, yes. Yeah, I had also this question, what happened when the points on the branch coincide? Yes, and then you get something, yes.
But no, what I meant is really that you can have, something which is cyclic, but it's constructed in a more complicated way. In degree two, there is only one possibility.
Yes.
But as soon as the degree is higher, then, as I said, you have more complicated pictures that can arise. And this is because there is this general classification in the PhD thesis of Rita Pardini of all abelian covers. And this in particular include cyclic covers which are not built in this straightforward way.
Okay, no.
Wanted to say that before you go all the way out to non-cyclic, there is an intermediate step.
Okay, that is a good point, thank you. So you mean non-simple cyclic, okay. No, I'm considering all the simpler ones, yes. No. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because, I don't know how will be the computation of the image in that case. So the dimension of this PD is based on has to look at how do the period matrices of the polarizations looks like. So we have to study that. This is a Shimura paper of the types of the period matrix, and study the automorphism there and compute the dimensions. So if everything is simple and simple cyclic, but the one is not, I don't know. I have to look how to check. What other cases are?
So just a method that doesn't apply in the more general case.
No, to check. But yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is a good suggestion. Mm-hmm. Have more questions?
Can I ask another question?
Yes, please.
For the pre-map, we can consider compactifications of this A5. Is there any way to extend the pre-map to a larger total space? So consider more singular
I guess you can. I haven't done it by simplicity, but I guess you allow all type of coverings of admissible, so admissibles in the sense of without this condition of being compact, the kernel of the norm map. You end up in the compactification. Now you have to decide which compactification the one you want to consider. Don't know what would be the most natural in this way. But I don't know any work on that. So the pre-Mac extended also farther than this. No, I don't know.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Yeah, but I think you can get all sorts of things in the image. So of course, dominant in the lower cases. Mm-hmm. Lower genus. Okay. Should I stop there?
Because I'm thinking, for example, cubic threefold case, we consider like a nodal cubic.
Yeah.
And we can still project a line from a line in the just get a nodal, maybe a nodal, just the.
Yeah, and you get a lowable covering in that case. Yes. Let me see if it is that done. I'm not sure that it was already considered in the work of Donaghy Smith. They did a lot of things there, but that case maybe not. No,
yeah.
Because they started with something very generic. Yeah, so generic already in this loci, but you can go in smaller loci and look at the fibers there. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Well, so I want to finish the course with this. Yes.
Maybe we can stop the recording now.
Yeah.
And.